This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Video on demand display VOD are systems which allow users to select and watch, listen to video or audio content when they choose to, rather than having to watch at a specific broadcast time. IPTV technology is often used to bring video on demand to televisions and personal computers. Television VOD systems can either stream content through a set-top box, a computer or other device, allowing viewing in real time, or download it to a device such as a computer. Digital video recorder, also called a personal video recorder or portable media player, for viewing at any time. The majority of cable and telco-based television providers offer both VOD streaming, including pay-per-view and free content, whereby a user buys or selects a movie or television program and it begins to play on the television set almost instantaneously, or downloading to a DVR rented from the provider, or downloaded onto a PC. For viewing in the future, internet television, using the internet, is an increasingly popular form of video on demand. VOD can also be accessed via desktop client applications such as iTunes. Some airlines offer VOD as in-flight entertainment to passengers through individually controlled video screens embedded in seatbacks or armrests, or offered via portable media players. Some video-on-demand services such as Netflix use a subscription model that requires users to pay a monthly fee to access a bundled set of content. Other services use an advertising-based model, where access is free for users, and the platforms rely on selling advertisements as a main revenue stream. Contents 1. Early development. 2. Functionality. 3. History. 4. Role of piracy and peer-to-peer. 5. Types of VOD. 51. Transactional video on demand. 52. Catch-up TV. 53. Subscription models. 54. Near video on demand. 55. Push video on demand. 56. Advertising video on demand. 6. See also. 7. Notes. 8. References. 9. Further reading. Early development. Developing VOD required extensive negotiations to identify a financial model that would serve both content creators and cable providers while providing desirable content for viewers. Key factors identified for determining the economic viability of the VOD model included VOD movie buy rates, Hollywood and cable operator revenue splits. Cable providers offered VOD as part of digital subscription packages, which by 2005, primarily allowed cable subscribers to only access an on-demand version of content that was already provided in linear distribution. Included in these packages were extras and bonus footage rather than full episodes of television shows. Functionality. Download and streaming video on demand systems provide the user with all of the features of portable media players and DVD players. Some VOD systems that store and stream programs from hard disk drives use a memory buffer to allow the user to fast forward and rewind videos. It is possible to put video servers on local area networks, in which case they can provide very rapid response to users. Streaming video servers can also serve a wider community via WAN, in which case the responsiveness may be reduced. Download VOD services are practical to homes equipped with cable modems or DSL connection. Servers for traditional cable and telco VOD services are usually placed at the cable head end, serving a particular market, as well as cable hubs in larger markets in the telco world. They are placed in either the central office or a newly created location called a video head end office. VHO history. From September 1994, a VOD service formed a major part of the Cambridge Digital Interactive Television trial in England. This provided video and data to 250 homes and a number of schools connected to the Cambridge cable network, later part of NTL, now Virgin Media. The MPEG-1 encoded video was streamed over an ATM network from an ICL media server to set-top boxes designed by Acorn Online Media. The trial commenced at a speed of 2 megabits per second to the home, subsequently increased to 25 megabits per second. The content was provided by the BBC and Anglia Television. Although a technical success, difficulty in sourcing content was a major issue, and the project closed in 1996. In 1998, Kingston Communications became the first UK company to launch a fully commercial VOD service and the first to integrate broadcast TV and internet access through a single set-top box using IP delivery over 8. ADSL by 2001, Kingston Interactive TV had attracted 15,000 subscribers after a number of trials. HomeChoice followed in 1999, but were restricted to London after attracting 40,000 customers. They were bought by Tiscali in 2006, who were in turn bought by TalkTalk in 2009. Cable TV providers Telewest and NTL, now Virgin Media, launched their VOD services in the United Kingdom in 2005, competing with the leading traditional pay TV distributor BSKYB. BSKYB responded by launching Sky by Broadband, later renamed Sky Anytime on PC. The service went live on 2 January 2006. Sky Anytime on PC uses a legal peer-to-peer approach, based on Contiki technology, to provide very high-capacity multi-point downloads of the video content instead of the video content all being downloaded from Sky servers. The content comes from multiple users of the system who have already downloaded the same content. Other UK TV broadcasters have implemented their own versions of the same technology, such as the BBC's iPlayer, which launched on the 25th of December 2007, and Channel 4's 4OD4 On Demand, which launched in late 2006. Another example of online video publishers using legal peer-to-peer technology is based on Giraffic technology, which was launched in early 2011 with large online video on demand publishers such as US-based VEOH and UK-based Crazes Online. Moviesbox movie rental service. The BBC, ITV and Channel 4 plan to launch a joint platform provisionally called Kangaroo in 2008. This was abandoned in 2009 following complaints investigated by the Competition Commission that same year. The assets of the defunct Kangaroo project were bought by Arqiva, who used the technology behind Kangaroo to launch the Seesaw service in February 2010, a year later. However, Seesaw was shut down from lack of funding. VOD services are now available in all parts of the United States, which has the highest global take-up rate of VOD. In 2010, 80% of American internet users had watched video online, and 42% of mobile users who downloaded video preferred apps to a normal browser. Streaming VOD systems are available on desktop and mobile platforms from cable providers in tandem with cable modem technology, who use the large downstream bandwidth present on cable systems to deliver movies and television shows to end users, who can typically pause, fast forward, and rewind VOD movies due to the low latency and random access nature of cable technology. The large distribution of a single signal makes streaming VOD impractical for most satellite television systems. Both EchoStar, Dish Network and DirecTV offer video on demand programming to PVR owning subscribers of their satellite TV service. Once the programs have been downloaded onto a user's PVR, he or she can watch, play, pause, and seek at their convenience. VOD is also quite common in more expensive hotels' VOD systems that store and provide a user interface for content downloaded directly from the internet are widely available. Citation needed. According to the European Audiovisual Observatory, 142 paying VOD services were operational in Europe at the end of 2006. The number increased to 650 by 2009 at the January 2010 Consumer Electronics Show in Las Vegas. SESMI CEO Bruno Patti and President Phil Weiser showed a set-top box with a 1TB hard drive which could be used for video-on-demand services previously offered through cable TV or broadband. A movie, for example, could be sent out once using a broadcast signal, rather than numerous times over cable or fiber optic lines, and this would not involve the expense of adding many miles of lines. SESMI planned to lease broadcast spectrum to offer a subscription service, which National Association of Broadcasters President Gordon H. Smith said would provide a superior picture to that of cable or satellite, at a lower cost. Role of piracy and peer-to-peer. The neutrality of this section is disputed. Relevant discussion may be found on the talk page. Please do not remove this message until conditions to do so are met. August 2016. Learn how and when to remove this template message. Although video on demand generally refers to delivery mechanisms operating in accordance with applicable laws, the motivation for the development of video on demand services can be traced back to peer-to-peer networking and the development of file-sharing software. These innovations proved that it was technically possible to offer the consumer potentially every film ever made, in a way which does not burden the original provider with the linear costs associated with centralized streaming media. Many legal services such as Spotify use peer-to-peer distribution to better scale their platforms, with the likes of Netflix considering doing so to cope with net neutrality problems from downstream providers. Torrenting is a popular alternative to legal streaming, with 6% of global internet traffic involved in file sharing applications. Types of VOD: transactional video on demand. Transactional video on demand TVOD is a distribution method by which customers pay for each individual piece of video on demand content. TVOD has two subcategories: electronic sell-through EST, by which customers can permanently access a piece of content once purchased via internet, and download to rent DTR, by which customers can access the content for a limited time upon renting. Examples of TVOD services include iTunes and Google Play. Catch-up TV: a growing number of TV stations offer catch-up TV as a way to watch TV shows, though their VOD service for a period of days after the original television broadcast. Some studies show that catch-up TV is starting to represent a large amount of the views and hours watched, and that users tend to watch catch-up TV programs for longer when compared to live TV subscription models. Subscription VODs: VOD services use a subscription business model, where subscribers are charged a monthly fee to access unlimited programs. These services include ShowMe, Netflix, Hulu Plus, Amazon Video, iFlix, Tonton, and HBO Go. Near video on demand. The examples and perspective in this section may not represent a worldwide view of the subject. Please improve this article or discuss the issue on the talk page. February 2015. Near video on demand NVOD is a pay-per-view consumer video technique used by multi-channel broadcasters using high-bandwidth distribution mechanisms such as satellite and cable television. Multiple copies of a program are broadcast at short time intervals, typically 10 to 20 minutes, providing convenience for viewers who can watch the program without needing to tune in at a scheduled point in time. This form is bandwidth intensive and is generally provided only by large operators with a great deal of redundant capacity, and has been reduced in popularity as video on demand is implemented. Only the satellite services Dish Network and DirecTV continue to seriously provide NVOD experiences out of necessity, as many of their customers have no access to their broadband VOD services before the rise of video on demand. Pay-per-view provider in demand facilitated this need by providing up to 40 channels in 2002, with several films receiving up to 4 channels on the staggered schedule to provide the NVOD experience. As of 2014, only 4 channels, 2 in high definition, 2 in standard definition, are provided to facilitate live and event coverage, along with existing league out of market sports coverage. Channels varied by provider. By the service in Australia, pay TV broadcaster Foxtel offers NVOD for new release movies. Push video on demand. Push video on demand is a technique used by a number of broadcasters on systems that lack connectivity to provide true video on demand, or by broadcasters who want to optimize their video streaming infrastructure by pre-loading the most popular contents to the consumer device. A push VOD system uses a personal video recorder PVR to store a selection of content, often transmitted in spare capacity overnight or all day long at low bandwidth. Users can watch the downloaded content at the time they desire, immediately and without any buffering issue. Push VOD depends on the viewer recording content, so choices can be limited as content occupies space on the PVR hard drive. Downloaded content is usually deleted after a week to make way for newer programs. The limited space on a PVR hard drive means that the selection of programs is usually restricted to most popular content. A new generation of push VOD solution recently appeared on the market, which, by using efficient error correction mechanisms, can free significant amount of bandwidth and that can deliver more than video, e.g. magazines, interactive applications, advertising. Video on demand. Advertising video on demand allows companies that advertise on broadcast and cable channels to reach people who watch shows using VOD, and this model allows people to watch programs without paying to subscribe. Hulu has been one of the major AVOD companies, though the company ended free service in August 2015. Ads still run on the subscription service, and Yahoo View continues the free AVOD model. Advertisers may find that people watching on VOD services do not want the same ads to appear multiple times. Crackle has introduced the concept of a series of ads for the same company that tie in to what is being watched. See also Internet Portal BitTorrent. Comparison of video hosting services. Music on demand. Electronic sell-through notes. Carrot. Broadband users control what they watch and when. Archived 20 April 2010 at the Wayback Machine. Carrot. Ritsuto, Ronald J. Worth, 2002. The Economics of Video on Demand, a Simulation Analysis. Journal of Media Economics 15:3-209 doi:101,207 per seconds 15,327,736 me 1503_5. Topics, Volume 05, Number 10, November 1995. Carat Sweeney, Mark 27 November 2007, broadcasters to launch joint VOD service. The Guardian London retrieved 13 January 2008. Carat Dixon, Glenn 9 January 2010, NAB shows off new spectrum applications, broadcasting. Video ecosystem, Variety retrieved 17 June 2015. University Press p. Digital Rights Management Gripe Site Intellectual Property Legal Aspects of File Sharing Mashup Digital Videos Music Piracy Orphan Works Patents Biological Software Patent Debate Trolling Public Domain Concepts All Rights Reversed Alternative Compensation System Anti-Copyright Notice Business Models for Open Source Software Copyleft Commercial Use of Copyleft Works Commons Based Peer Production Free Content Free Software License InfoAnarchism Libertarian Positions Open Content Open Design Open Music Model Open Patent Open Source Hardware Open Source Software Prize System Contests Share alike video on demand movements access to knowledge movement anti-copyright cultural environmentalism free culture movement free software movement organizations copyright alliance creative commons electronic frontier foundation free software foundation open rights group organization for transformative works the pirate bay pirate byron pirate party Sci-Hub Students for Free Culture People Alexandra Elbakian Rickard Falkvinge Lawrence Lessig Richard Stallman Peter Sunda Peter Suber Aaron Swartz Documentaries Steal This Film 2006, 2007 Good Copy Bad Copy 2007 Rip, A Remix Manifesto 2008 TPBAFK, The Pirate Bay Away From Keyboard 2013 The Internet's Own Boy 2014